tremendous variety of different kinds of immigrant foodways in Houston. According to various studies, the most diverse major metropolitan area in the United States, and thus probably one of the most diverse metropolitan areas in the world. I'm Todd Romero. I'm an associate professor of history at the University of Houston, where I co-direct the Gulf Coast Food Project. For a long time, Houston was a biracial city. It was primarily a white and an African-American city. It had that common history in the South of slavery, and that certainly shaped the way that people ate here. By the 20th century, that starts to change. At the end of the 19th century, growing numbers of Mexicans start moving to Houston to work initially. And by 1910, the Mexican Revolution gives sort of a push factor that people are coming less for jobs and more because of turmoil. And after 1910, it increasingly becomes a tri-racial city, so that Mexican food for a long time, and not just, you know, Mexican food as a monolith, but the wide variety of different regional foodways have come, and Mexican foodways have come and shaped Houston food in profound ways, along with the development of Tex-Mex food, which is sort of a distinct regional Mexican food that is our own.
My restaurant, it's like very diverse. I really cater to everybody. It's family owned, family run. Whenever I get a chance and speak to people, I'll tell them, you know what, have a seat and I'll take care of you as like you at your house. We started as a bakery. We didn't have the dining area we have now. Other side was just bakery, Mexican bread at that. As time went by, our own customers would tell us, hey, you should add breakfast. So like, all right, so we added breakfast. And then they said, you should add lunch. So like, all right, we added lunch. So pretty much the area we're in right now, the dining area, it used to be a hair salon, you know, years ago. So as soon as they closed the hair salon, we took over, you know, we tore down the wall, moved in, and that's how we became, you could say, like a full-blown restaurant now. My uncle, he opened up the first bakery like in the early 80s. And it's still going, and actually that's where we get our coffee from. He's roasting coffee over there now, and we're bringing it over here, and that's the coffee we serve here. It's Café de Olla. It's a cinnamon-infused coffee.
What makes it great?
The spices. You know, I like the food that's spicy. A lot of people will agree with me that, you know, if it's not spicy, it doesn't feel like it's Mexican, it feels like it's Tex-Mex. You know, it has to be spicy, and it has to be flavorful. I think, and it's gotta be made with love. You know, food, you know, if you make it with love, you know, people are gonna tell. You know, spiciness with love, a good combination, you get a good Mexican food.
From China, southwest of China, the food is spicy and tingling. Be careful, not just the spicy. The tingling makes your mouth and the tongue a little bit numb, but that one is very good for the health of joints. My mother-in-law's mom learned from the cook, then passed all the recipe to her. She teach me all the recipe. The pepper twins chicken, we use the spring mountain chicken, no hormonal antibiotics. The meat is full protein, it's very good for kids and for adults. The pepper, this pepper is special. Actually, we put two kinds of pepper. One is red Thai pepper, another one is green red Thai pepper. the Thai pepper a little similar like my hometown the pepper. So we try to find the fresh vegetable from local, but the dry pepper from my hometown directly. Then we add one peppercorn. The peppercorn is a special ingredient. That one is very good for the health of our joint. So when the peppercorn with the pepper together, the flavor is so rich. You can, any of the guests love this dish, they can tell you how delicious the food. The favorite part is see the smile on our guests. Mm-hmm. Once I see them enjoying our food, it's very happy.
Is the Polish roots here. My husband immigrated to Houston about 20 years ago. The reason we opened the restaurant and store is that my husband's living here already like 4 or 5 years, and you know, he just loved Polish food, and so he wanted to try the Polish food. But there was only like one small store in the Houston area, and for Easter he went there to go buy some kielbasa, which is sausage, and they already ran out by 10 o'clock in the morning. And my husband said, never again, I want to be in Christmas or Easter, you know, no Polish traditions. At the beginning, we just opened our store, and he asked me, do you want to open up a restaurant? I said, no way, I don't want a restaurant. I could do the store, but no restaurant. And then he eventually convinced me to open up a restaurant. People hear about us, or there's people that have, you know, different Polish roots, maybe second, third generation Poles that come to our store and restaurant. I think it's nice when, you know, the customers come in and they really enjoy our food, and I think that's one of the most important things. I mean, almost everyone that works for us is all Polish. I'm like the only one that's not Polish, but everyone is Polish here. Mm-hmm. So they really do get that atmosphere. They get to speak Polish. The Polish food store, we have people come in and they say, I want kielbasa. Well, we have like 30 different kinds of kielbasa. You know, kielbasa is sausage, so they have different types of sausage. Some are smoked heavier. We only have one raw sausage, which a lot of people like eat that during like the Christmas season, or they have that for Easter. We have a few like t-shirts and hats, you know, I love Poland, or pray for me, my husband's Polish. But I mean, we're only the only restaurant, Polish restaurant in the state of Texas. So.
We are a brand name. We have 4 outlets in Mumbai, 2 in Dubai, 1 in Kochi, and 1 in Houston. So this is like a brand name that we own by the family. It's not a franchise. And Thali has been in our culture for thousands of years. And the good part is that what we are trying to do is keep the same menu in all our outlets around the world. I've been getting this mix that everybody says, why not New York? Mm. Number one, I'm not a follower, I'm a leader. And the reason why I chose Houston, you get each and every Indian vegetable you can think about. I'm telling you, I'm really impressed. Well, this is the Thali style, which is very unique. It's like a sit-down buffet where the food is served to you on the table. You don't have to go behind the food comes to you. Whenever we went out to eat in any part of the nation, anywhere, it's like nobody wanted to do the real style of Indian food. It's like, more or less to say, it can't be more authentic than this. We wanted people to experience what is fine dining and what the name of our restaurant also signifies. Maharaja Bhog means where kings eat. So the biggest point was to give the customer the taste of food and royalty.
Texas for over 20 years now. We came across this location and it was first good fit at the drive-through and started finding the meats and creating the recipes and started inviting friends over to try the food and get their thoughts on it. Everybody liked it. Do meats from all over the world. And kangaroo and camel come from Australia. Python snake, we do our chili, that comes from Vietnam. Sometimes we get our elk from New Zealand, sometimes it's local here in the US. We have iguana that we serve with our empanadas, and that comes from Puerto Rico as well. So a lot of it is free range, natural, no hormones, antibiotics. So it is something healthy, exotic, and delicious at the same time. So we get our kangaroo, we'll grind it in-house, and make our own patties, and grill them up. The sliders, which is our more popular dish. So today we have venison, kangaroo, and then the one in the middle with our flag, that's emu. It comes on a soft pretzel bun, so we have it baked locally here. Sogo Bakery is one of the best bakeries in town. So we get it baked fresh every day. And the python chili fries are really popular too. A lot of people have never tried steak before. It's got a shredded python meat from elk, and we melt some cheddar cheese on top. And, place in town with